It's another episode of the Senator Omer Raines Show. Come join us here at the Reno Town Mall, get in the audience, or get behind a microphone. You can also text in questions at 775-237-2266 to speak with Senator Omer Raines or his guests. That number is 844-790-TALK. Again, it's 844-790-8255. Without further ado, let's get to the creator and host, Senator Omer Raines.
Thank you, Eddie. Hello, folks. I'm Omer Raines, welcoming you to America Matters Media, broadcasting this program live to the world, not only in English, but by way of translation in various other languages as well. As listeners know, this weekly program, by choice, is eclectic in nature and does not focus solely on one topic or subject matter. However, whatever the topic, whomever the guest, we encourage diverse points of view. Therefore, we welcome comments or questions from the listening audience. And Eddie has provided you with the key numbers. Now, folks, today's program will revisit sports, as it's another of those times during the year when several major sports activities converge, starting, of course, with the World Series. But in addition, we have NBA basketball playoffs fast approaching. We have the collegiate programs of football well underway, and that means basketball is not far behind. The NFL playoffs are on the horizon. The NBA program is fast along, and we're going to talk about all these today. So anyway, to discuss these and many other matters, time permitting, I want to briefly introduce today's guest, Andrew Woolf. Now, listeners to this program may recall that I've had Andy on before. Why do I bring him back? Because whatever the time of year, whatever the sport, Andy's on top of it. It's really quite amazing, but after all, as a partner of the world-class sports agency based in L.A., he and his partners booked, over the years, athletes and coaches in over 5,000 roles. And they sometimes dealt with commercials, modeling, celebrity events, and so on and so forth. So today I'm not, again, going to go through Andy's long history in sports agency and management, but suffice it to say that it goes back over three decades to his college years when he did receive a master's degree in sports management. Along the way, he's represented in one capacity or another noted sports personalities in football, basketball, baseball, boxing, gymnastics, track and field, and so on and so forth. I could keep going. One last thing, as Andy knows, when we discuss future events on this program, I generally hold his feet to the fire and cause him to make predictions. Sometimes he's wrong, but more times than not, he's spot on. So, welcome, Andy, again.
Well, thank you, Senator. I'm happy to be back.
Well, I want to start, obviously, well, I should say obviously, but it's of the moment, with the World Series. I think, in my opinion, baseball no longer is the supergiant that it was as I was growing up. But it is still the most American of sports. And for the second season in a row, the World Series, I think, may turn into a classic. So, tell me what you think about the first two games and the upcoming game tonight, actually.
Well, tonight's game is at Dodger Stadium, and the weather's going to be warm. It's going to be probably in the 80s in downtown L.A., during the daytime. It'll be in the 60s, low 70s during the day. And, you know, playing at Fenway Park is a big advantage for the Red Sox because it's an unusual ballpark. And, you know, and when they played the first two games, it was very cold at night. The temperatures got down to the 40s. So the Red Sox had the advantage. They were used to the cold weather playing in the previous playoff games and also in April. And the Dodgers were not accustomed to the cold weather, and I think the manager Dave Roberts made some pitching mistakes on the relief pitchers, and they paid for it. But they need to win tonight. It's imperative that the Dodgers win tonight.
Well, in one way, it's a dream matchup in that the executives at Fox Sports and others involved in baseball got the dream matchup they wanted. These two major, huge media markets. But after that, there are some differences. You know, these are in the top 10 media markets in the country. However, a lot of people will not be as interested as they might have been were it in the Midwest or the East. But that remains to be seen. I think your comment is correct. I mean, there's a huge advantage when you're playing in Fenway Park because the crowd there is demonstrably in favor of the home team, as they ought to be, and it's hard to play there. L.A. doesn't have the same crowd type of environment. I mean, let's face it, L.A., you can be sipping Mai Tais and talking to neighbors. You may hoping to be seen. You may be on the beach. You may be in your own swimming pool. I mean, it's not quite the same. I think you would agree with that.
Absolutely. Believe it or not, Dodger Stadium is the third oldest ballpark in the major leagues behind Fenway and Wrigley Field.
I find that amazing, but I read that recently. Well, look, the Dodgers have this incredible pitcher in Clayton Kershaw, and yet he's not done well historically in post-season events, and that includes this one so far. But they've also got probably the most valuable player in the National League this year in Mookie Betts. And, of course, this incredible talent in Yasiel Puig. But on the other hand, the Red Sox have been the dominant team this year. They have a record 108 wins. So where do you see the last two or more games of this series going?
Well, it's imperative that the Dodgers win tonight. So, if they win tonight, it's 2-1. Boston, they need to sweep. I don't think the Dodgers, if they only win two of the three games at Dodger Stadium, I don't think they can win two games, game six and seven in Fenway. The Red Sox just have an advantage, and plus it's going to could possibly be down in the 30s for both games. You just have to give Boston the edge. You know, in the previous series, they split the first two games in Milwaukee, the Dodgers. They won two out of three in Dodger Stadium and lost the sixth game, but they won the final, the seventh game. This time they lost the first two games in Boston, so they need to sweep in L.A. to have a chance.
Okay. Well, look, we're going to take our first commercial break, and when we come back, I think we'll take up football, probably both professional and college, and maybe in that order. Stay tuned, folks. We'll be right back.
Despite the recent changes in healthcare, there are many of you, for whatever reason, are still without healthcare, or you don't like the very few choices of physicians that accept your insurance. With the cold and flu season just around the corner, now is the time to call Sonia Rich Mazzio at the Alma Clinic for Family Healthcare, accepting new patients and all insurance plans. Self-pay, sliding scale, and three age bracket-oriented plans that are all well under $100 a month, and which include yearly checkup and three or more yearly visits, either in person or on video. Call 775-683-3833 or go to almaclinic.com. They're located at 1321 North McCarran Boulevard, Suite 104 in Sparks. Mention you heard this on America Matters and receive a $75 value waiver for your registration fee. Alma Clinic for Family Health Care, 775-683-3833 or almaclinic.com. 775-683-3833, because health insurance shouldn't cost an arm and a leg.
Hey everyone, Dave Escher here introducing you to our new store, the Nevada Marketplace, in the Reno Town Mall. Anchored with the Buy Nevada First gift shop, we've added over 60 micro shops, giving locals a place to set up their dream store. We are now 20,000 square feet strong, supporting over 250 local merchants with all things made in Nevada and more. We have more locals in one place than anywhere in the state, ready to help you find that perfect gift. We're open every day with easy parking at Peckham and Virginia. Go to buynevadafirst.com, your source for all things local.
Another Monday, another season. Out to lunch. Mondays at noon on 1180 KCKQ America Matters. Number one in Reno for community radio. I'm Deidre, your host. Do you have something interesting going on that you want to talk about? Speak up and be heard. I've had tax attorneys, bands, artists, fundraisers, authors, Elks, doctors, lawyers, and Indian chiefs. Anyone interesting with something going on can come be on the show. Let the community know all about it. Do you have something interesting or a charitable event going on? Mondays at noon, out to lunch on America Matters, 1180 KCKQ, also streaming live and podcasted on americamatters.us. That's also where you can contact me, Deidre, at americamatters.us. Or you can find me at the Elbow Room, Wednesday through Fridays, 2002 Victorian Avenue in Sparks. Call 358-6700. Out to lunch with Deidre, Mondays at noon, 1180 AM KCKQ, America Matters, streaming live on americamatters.us. Number one in Reno Community Radio.
The Read and Succeed Book Program needs your help. They're looking for volunteers to do community book drives, fundraise for the Read and Succeed Program, recruit new volunteers, train them to clean and sort books, manage the book program, and a lot more. Read and Succeed helps K-6 students in the Washoe County School District struggling in reading and focuses on improving a child's fluency and comprehension. If you want to help, just call 775-348-0346. That's 775-348-0346.
This is America Matters Media on AM 1180 KCKQ, a Lotus broadcast station, the power of radio since 1967.
To join the conversation, call 844-790-TALK. That's 844-790-8255. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back again, folks. Omar Raines here with my guest, Andy Woolf, one of the most conversant sports talents in all of our country. And it's a pleasure always to have him. Andy, I want to convert now or transition into professional football. The season is well underway. Things are beginning to shake out. There have been quite a few surprises, but the dominance by some quarterbacks has been extraordinary. I mean, we've got this Patrick Holmes with Kansas City who is setting record after record given this incredible start. You've got Drew Brees of the New Orleans Saints who, number one, has now become the most prolific passer in some respects in NFL history in that he's gained more yards than any other quarterback. He also now has passed for 500 career touchdowns. I think there are only four in the history of the NFL that can say that. You've got this guy, Deshaun Watson, whose game last night quarterbacking for Houston was one of the more extraordinary performances I've seen in a long time. Five touchdown passes. More touchdown passes than he had incompletions. I think he was, 15 out of 20 or anyway, whatever it was an amazing performance. And, of course, you got to always bring in Aaron Rodgers because I think, and many people agree, that he's actually the best quarterback talent in the NFL on the planet. But he does not have a surrounding cast. He has no running game. He has a weak offensive line. And he's injured. So, and they have to play the Rams this weekend. So give me your breakdown. Am I way off base?
Well, you're omitting one quarterback from Cal, Jared Goff, who's completed nearly 70% of his passes and has thrown only five interceptions. That's just incredible.
Well, I'm a big Jared Goff fan, so I didn't omit him other than he is surrounded by a great cast this year and probably the best runner in professional football in Todd Gurley.
Absolutely. And the Rams offense, the only one that could stop the Rams offense are the Rams themselves. But with all the passing that they do, and they're not short passes, to throw only five interceptions. And I think last year he only threw 10 interceptions and he had 40 touchdown passes. Yeah, that's a 4-to-1 ratio. That is just superb because it used to be a 2-to-1 ratio was considered superb. He may even surpass what he did last year. But the Rams, you know, the question mark with the Rams is do they have the defense? They've had some injuries in the defensive backfield. So, you know, they do play the Packers at the Coliseum on Sunday. You know, the weather will be perfect. And it's on natural grass. which the Packers play at Lambeau Field. But do the Packers, can they get into a shootout with the Rams? I think the best spectators in that game could be the punters on both sides. They may not even get on the field.
That could well be. If Rodgers gets hot, notwithstanding the lack of a supporting cast, notwithstanding an injury, there's no one better.
And the Rams had 7 sacks against the 49ers last Sunday at Levi Stadium in Santa Clara.
You know, the 49ers have a lot of new talent, very young. They've not coalesced. But the big problem, of course, is the injury to Garoppolo. And I don't see them going very far unless that is addressed, because Beathard's just not up to it.
Well, you're absolutely correct. Garoppolo makes he's a top 10 quarterback, and he makes a big difference.
What about, there have been so many unusual things. One of them, I think his name's Justin Tucker. Anyway, he's the kicker for the Baltimore Ravens, who had made, 204 consecutive PATs, and then he missed one.
Correct.
And cost them the game. And I've never seen anybody with eyes wider open than his eyes after that PAT went awry. Anyway.
Well, then, when the NFL moved it back 10 yards, it made a big difference.
Well, it has not made a difference to him until until a week ago. But it made a big one then. Deion Sanders, I saw Deion Sanders being interviewed saying, he was interviewing Tucker, and Tucker said, everybody kept coming up to me after the game saying, it's not your fault, it's not your fault, it's not your fault, all my teammates. And Deion Sanders says, if your teammates are saying it's not your fault, it's your fault. And anyway, he's a great kicker, and he can't be remembered for that. So what has surprised you about the NFL this year?
I would say the scoring. The scoring is up. It's more entertaining. The ratings have leveled off and in some cases have gone up. They've had better featured games in the NFL for Monday Night Football, Thursday Night Football, Sunday Night Football. They've had the best games, most competitive games this year compared to the last 5 years. And so the ratings haven't declined. They've leveled off. The last 2 years, ratings declined overall about 1/6. So the NFL is happy. Plus, they've been lucky. The Rams are doing well. The Chargers, I think, are the most underrated team in football. They're doing well. So the ratings in San Diego are higher. The ratings in L.A. are higher for the Chargers. And, New England is New England. Minnesota is having a good year. So there haven't really been too many surprises, with the except the Rams. I don't think anybody expected the Rams to be 7-0, and they could be 8-0 on Sunday.
But there are problems, are there not? For like over-commercialization, there are now, I think, 8 games being shown each week. And for a 60-minute game, you see, according to statistical analysis, 12 minutes of actual football. And the rest of the time, there are TV commercials jammed to a game, an endless array of tired ads for vehicles, beer, wireless services, pharmaceutical ads, and so on and so forth. And it takes nearly 4 hours commitment to watch the entire game on TV. And, when you contrast that with major soccer, it's 90 minutes of continuous action with only a few commercials at halftime. That's a big difference. TV ratings may be kind of plateauing, but they certainly went down over the last few years.
Well, that's absolutely correct. I think baseball's got even a bigger problem. Man, they're having 9-inning games during the playoffs that are 4 hours, 4 hours and 15 minutes. The game is being micromanaged by both sides, and all the relief changes, and they need to speed up the game. And, some of these pitchers are taking 30, 40 seconds between pitches. It should be, no more than 20 seconds. a baseball game, a nine-inning game should not take more than 2.5 hours.
Well, I agree. I watched that first game, and it drove me crazy because, you know, especially when Ryu was pitching, because he's stepping off the mound, the hitter's out of the box, he's scratching his, you know what, he's spitting.
Right.
He's hitting his cleats to get any mud off, getting back in. There are these commercial breaks, and it just goes on and on and on. But anyway, it is what it is. You are absolutely right. Both professional football and professional baseball, they've got to speed these games up. What about the other issues that are so prominent when it comes especially to football? That is like domestic violence or CTE or brain damage and so on and so forth.
Well, I think the NFL's taking a stand on the violence. I think there was a quarterback, I can't remember what the team, that he got kicked off the team for a domestic violence problem. His last name is Kelly, not related to Jim Kelly, but and he got released. So I think the NFL is putting down the hammer on these players that are having off-the-field violence issues. So they've had less this year than they've had the last 2 years.
Well, Roger Goodell seems to enjoy the confidence of the owner simply because whether he makes good decisions or bad decisions, they seem to be financially benefiting all along the way. So, and as a result, you don't even see allegiance to cities by these billionaire owners. I mean, Baltimore became Indianapolis, Los Angeles became St. Louis, and now St. Louis has again become Los Angeles. There's this hope that Oakland will relocate to Las Vegas. There has been a vote. But we've got the history of the Davis family, several moves, threatened moves. So do you think the Raiders will actually move to Las Vegas?
Yes. The Oakland Alameda Coliseum is the worst stadium in pro football. And I believe they're starting to build the stadium in Vegas.
Yes, they are. If the Raiders don't come, they may end up with a white elephant because they won't fill that stadium just with the UNLV games and other things of that nature down in Vegas alone.
Yeah, but the Raider games will only be 10 games a year, including exhibitions, not including, you know, the playoffs if they make it. They're not going to make the playoffs, you know, definitely not this year, but, you know, maybe when by the time they move to Vegas, you know, they may be a playoff-bound team.
Could be, but that's part of my point, that you're going to have, if they have only 10 games a year, do they have a full stadium? There's going to be a lot of unhappy people who have, in effect, financed that stadium. We're going to take another commercial break, Andy. We'll be right back. Folks, stay with us. We're coming into collegiate football next, I believe. I think we'll do that. Okay?
Hi, I'm Hugh Roy Marshall from the Marshall Men, Virginia City and Reno, Nevada. I'm to introduce you to the Let 'Em Run Wild Horse Mustang Series, which depicts the Wild Mustang's herd running free, mare and its foal, the Wild Mustang's fighting for love. These ingots are a limited edition double struck product on 1 troy ounce 3 fine silver and are only available at the Marshall Mint, Virginia City, or Reno, Nevada. Get your piece of history today.
We're talking to Victor from Precision Diamonds. Victor, where do I go to get my jewelry fixed?
You need to come to Precision Diamonds and meet Mo. Mo is the best jeweler in town. He's been with me 17 years. He has an amazing following. Everything's done in-house. You'll be surprised how many customers, how many friends will not let anybody else touch their jewelry except for Moses.
Mo is a part of your family.
He is my nephew. He is the future of the business. We've created a design center where we can create design exactly what you're looking for, and if it's just a matter of coming in, let us inspect it, clean it, so make sure that everything's safe, everything gets done while you wait. If you have a very specific job to be done that needs to be done while you wait, let's call us, come on in, let's set up an appointment, and he'll talk to you and tell you the whole process of what he's doing while you wait, while you watch him. This way there's never a question about what was done, and he guarantees everything.
So see Mo at Precision Diamonds.
Absolutely, come and see us.
Thank you, Victor. Precision Diamonds, your local jeweler across from the convention center.
You love your car, and so does Car Checks. For about $2.50 a day, you get the peace of mind in knowing that your expensive repair bills may be covered by a vehicle protection plan. For about $2.50 a day, you can make sure you don't get stuck with a bill for covered repairs. For a completely free quote, visit us at GetProtected.com. 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 That's GetProtected.com.
Hi, this is Ken Roberts, the host of Ken's Bulls and Bears Report. If you own real estate, paper, and other assets, congratulations. Now, you need protection. We live in a litigious society. Those with assets are sued all the time. Are you next? Protect your assets with solid asset protection strategies. Contact my friend Garrett Sutton and the Sutton Law Center. Garrett and his team provide affordable asset protection services with strong LLC and corporate formations in all 50 states. Better yet, they help maintain your entity on an ongoing basis so you're protected into the future. Garrett has written the bestsellers Start Your Own Corporation and Loopholes of Real Estate, among others, in the Rich Dad Advisor series. He knows asset protection. Visit his website at sutlaw.com. That's sutlaw.com or call 800-700-1430. Sutton Law Center can help you protect your hard-earned assets. Call 800-700-1430 today or visit sutlaw.com. Protect your assets now at sutlaw.com.
Find out what's hot and happening. Join Lady J for Smooth Jazz Tune-Up.
Join me Saturdays, 10 to noon, here on America Matters.
Are you shy and don't want to talk on the air? Text us your questions or comments to 775 237-2266.
Welcome back again, folks. Omer Raines here. Our guest is Andy Woolf, and we're talking sports today. So before we go to collegiate football, I do want to make one other comment and ask your opinion about this. Probably the most influential athlete in football, whether you like him or dislike him, remains Colin Kaepernick. Which is that controversy has dragged in players, coaches, fans, owners, even the president of the United States. What, what's going to happen here?
I think Kaepernick may be a lifetime free agent. I don't think there's one NFL team that wants to pick him up because of all the negative publicity.
Well, that's my point. There is that, and yet his regalia. His shirts and, you know, what have you, is number one seller still in professional football. So that's why I say it's dragged in so many different groups and people and fans and coaches and, as I say, even the president. So nobody's going to sign him. And what will that mean? Just ongoing litigation for a long time or what?
Absolutely. You know, he'll file a lawsuit for collusion of the NFL owners.
Well, that's going to be very interesting to follow. So anyway, let's transition on to collegiate football. We're not near December 2 when the eight teams will be selected by the committee for the playoffs. But where do you think things stand right now, and where do you think they are going? I mean, Alabama is clearly number one right now in the rankings. Deservedly so.
Clemson and Notre Dame are right behind them. Georgia's lost one game. Michigan's lost one game. I think those are, and, you know, Ohio State's lost one game. I think those are your top six teams.
Well, you know, our executive producer here at American Matters Media, Eddie Floyd, should be really happy because between Florida, his alma mater, Central Florida and South Florida, I think they've only lost one game. South Florida, I think, is still undefeated, and I believe Central Florida is as well, and Florida's only... No, they're both undefeated, and I think Florida has lost one game. So...
Yeah, I think Miami's only lost one or two games.
I think they've lost at least two, haven't they?
Right, it's Florida State that's lost, I think, three games.
Florida State has, but not the University of Florida. Correct.
Right, but I'm talking about Miami and Coral Gables.
I realize that. But I do think they've had a couple of losses. I think they're maybe about 6-2, something like that. But anyway,
right.
Something to be followed. Can you go way out on a limb and try to break down the eight teams that may eventually be selected?
Well, is it going to be eight teams this year? Since they've tried the playoff, it's been four teams.
Well, I thought I read that they were going to go to eight teams because there were so many last year, so controversial, because so many that seemingly became eligible, but for one reason or another, they were overlooked. I mean, we had basically the Blue Bloods, and that will probably happen again this year. But go ahead and give me eight, and then give me four then.
All right. Well, I think right now the top four right now are Alabama, Clemson, Notre Dame, and Michigan.
Okay.
But I think Michigan has to play at Ohio State. And then you got, you know, Ohio State. You got LSU. You got Georgia. And, boy, the eighth team. Well, the Pac-10. You know, I've been very impressed with Washington State. They've only lost one game, and they play Washington in Pullman this year. And they just have, you know, a great coach in Mike Leach, and they have a great quarterback in who's a transfer from East Carolina. So Washington State's got a, you know, a great offense.
Well, Washington State, absolutely.
So those are,
what was it, Oregon that Washington State demolished last week? And Oregon was ranked pretty high.
Right. They beat Oregon by about 17 points. They were up 28-0 or 27-0 in the first half.
It's been a long time since Washington State has enjoyed this kind of success on the football field. University of Washington often has, but not Washington State.
Correct.
Okay, that, you know, we're going to hold you to those predictions as time goes by, and we don't have that long to go. Did you can you narrow your eight down to four now?
Oh, you know, Alabama, of course, as long as their quarterback is healthy. Clemson, Notre Dame, and Michigan.
Hmm. Okay. Well, yeah.
Notre Dame has kind of a soft schedule. You know, they do have to play USC at the Coliseum at the end of the year.
Interesting selections. Well, actually, they're all fairly predictable. I think Michigan may be a bit more of an iffy situation, mainly because they have to play what is probably a better team in Ohio State, but we'll see. Maybe not. Anything else about the collegiate ranks in football right now that you think we ought to discuss?
Well, I think it's, you know, whatever team is the healthiest at the end of the season is going to be the favorite, and you can't bet against Alabama and Nick Saban.
I don't think there's anyone in the country that would disagree with that, and it ought to be that way simply because he makes more money than any football coach in the land, a lot more.
And more than most, I think more than any pro coach.
Oh, absolutely. Yes, any football coach in the land. Right, collegiate or professional. So they better get their money's worth out of this guy. And they have. All right. Well, let's go on and talk a little bit of basketball then. Well, let me ask you a question. It'll be out of left field. David Stern's a longtime friend of mine. Of course, he's been retired as commissioner of the NBA for many, many years now. But be that as it may, I keep hearing, and I haven't spoken to him recently, but I keep hearing that he's got something in plan that will dramatically improve professional basketball and make it more accepted worldwide. Do you have any idea what that's all about?
He may want to have a world basketball championship. You know, there was a featured article in the basketball issue of Sports Illustrated, the most recent issue of Sports Illustrated, about a 6-7 page article, and it did not disclose what he was going to do, but he says he's got something that he's working on, and he's very close with Adam Silver, the current commissioner of the NBA. So I think he wants to do a world basketball championship. Now, that could be a collection of all-stars of the NBA, or it could be the NBA champion.
Well, just as Larry O'Brien handpicked David Stern, in effect, handpicked Adam Silverman. So I think more than one person probably knows what's going on, but Stern clearly is keeping this very, very close to his vest to the extent possible.
The only other thing that could be a possibility is NBA teams located outside of North America.
Well, there's been so much discussion about NBA and NFL as well, going to London, going to Mexico City, and certain other international venues, and that may well happen. We know that. And, of course, the NFL is playing a game in London many times during the year now, including this weekend.
And the Rams play the Chiefs in Mexico City this year.
Yes.
A Monday night game.
Yep.
Okay. And you got, you know, that's a higher altitude than Denver. That's 7,800 feet in Mexico, and Denver's 5,200 feet. That makes a big difference.
As the 1968 Summer Olympics well evidenced and proved.
And it was 50 years ago this year. Actually, 50 years ago this month.
Among others.
You know, the Mexico City Summer Olympics, you know, and the famous Bob Beamon long jump of 29.2 and a half.
Oh, my God. That was unbelievable, except the only explanation was the altitude.
Right.
Oh, wow. What a lifty.
And very few people know that was made, and the jump was made during the qualifying round, and it was the first jump he made, and he didn't jump again. He only made one jump in the whole competition.
He didn't have to. I think the eyes of everyone in the world, every sports fan, were that wide open, including his. Unless somebody's going to do as well, why do more? Okay. Well, now we've got, I'll tell you what, we're going to take an early break before we go into collegiate basketball and also NBA basketball. So, folks, again, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Are you planning to move? Paragon Real Estate Resources can help you sell or buy a home anywhere in the United States. We provide a home resources coordinator to manage all aspects of your move. We recommend qualified real estate agents and other services to prepare your home for sale. Best of all, if you sell or buy a home with our assistance, you could be eligible to receive a tax-free real estate commission cash rebate. We can also help you obtain a mortgage at competitive interest rates. Our lenders offer fixed and adjustable rates, conforming and non-conforming loans, plus FHA and VA financing. We can also assist first-time buyers with as little as 5% down. And when it comes time to move, we can refer you to qualified movers or other companies to assist with self-moves. Paragon Real Estate Resources helps make moving as easy as possible. Call Paragon Real Estate Resources now at 1-800-235-7513 to learn more or visit ParagonRERI.com.
Ready for a live game of Clue? For nearly 30 years, Funtime Theater has held private and monthly dinner murder mysteries. Each night is different, and each event includes dinner and a show. You're the detective, and your job is to figure out who did what to who and why. At the end of the night, a super sleuth and not so super sleuth are awarded prizes. This is a great event for a birthday or holiday party and team building events for your office. Visit FuntimeTheater.com to make your reservations and use promo code RADIO for $5 off each admission.
Have you, a friend, or family member been diagnosed with cancer? Dr. Forsyth at the Forsyth Cancer Care Center offers an all-inclusive program to treat adult types of cancer. The Forsyth Immune Protocol Cancer Treatment Plan, in a current prospective study of over 6.5 years and 1,200 adult cancer patients, has produced a remarkable 30 times greater survival statistic when compared to conventional full-dose chemotherapy. Greater than 95% of all their patients choose low-dose insulin-potentiated life chemotherapy. Therapy using only 10 to 15% chemotherapy dosing with insulin. Dr. Forsyth has long been considered one of the most respected physicians in the United States, particularly for his treatment of cancer and the legal use of human growth hormone. Located in Reno, Nevada, Dr. Forsyth has seen patients from all over the world. To schedule your consultation today, call 775-827-0707. That number again is 775-827-0707.
You've heard heard of Candelaria's Mexican restaurants? Well, there's more to Candelaria's than just Mexican for lunch and dinner. Now at the Reno location, Candelaria's is open for your favorite American breakfast and lunch. Located at 180 West Peckham in the Reno Town Mall Annex, Candelaria's is serving breakfast starting at 6 a.m. And for lunch, mix and match your Mexican and American favorites for the best of both worlds. Come see Candelaria's today. Carry out and delivery is also available. Just call 449-5502 to place your order today.
This is America Matters Media on AM 1180 KCKQ, a Lotus broadcast station. The power of radio since 1967.
Want to expand your advertising dollar? Sponsor this or any America Matters program by calling 775-827-8900, extension 2.
Welcome back again, folks. Omer Raines here. Our guest is Andy Woolf, and we're talking sports. As we went to commercial break, we were talking NBA basketball. Now, on the surface, the Warriors seem to be the class, at least in the opinion of most people. I mean, they've got Stephen Curry, they've got Kevin Durant, they've got Klay Thompson, they've got Draymond Green. It just goes on and on and on. And now they've signed DeMarcus Cousins. And when he returns from his Achilles injury, this might be the most talented starting five in NBA history. Who's going to challenge them?
I think there's only two teams that could challenge them, and that's Houston and the Boston Celtics.
And give me the reasons why you think they could challenge.
Well, you know, I think if Chris Paul did not get injured in the series against the Warriors, they may have won the playoff against the Warriors. They had the home court advantage. And so it all depends on Chris Paul. And there's nobody that could guard Harden. And they got Carmelo Anthony, and they brought back Capella. And there's rumors they want to get Butler from Minnesota. And then Boston, they would meet in the finals. You know, if Hayward's healthy and Kyrie Irving's healthy, they're going to be tough to beat.
Well, you know, I find it fascinating that all of that, of course, is true. But I still look, and you've got a team, the Warriors, that have bidding for their fourth title in 5 years, if my recollection's correct. You know, they had a preseason.
If they win this year, it'll be four out of five.
Right. They had a preseason this year where they won only one game, and they had precisely zero concern, and I think deservedly so. They were laughing and playing, you know, all sorts of players and seeing who could gel, but they are absolutely stocked and stacked. And with DeMarcus Cousins coming in, probably the at least physically, with the most talent of any center, true center in professional football, joining the party. I mean, it's mind-boggling. The five Warrior starters could potentially, I suppose, start for an international team. They're that good. So,
they have five all-stars.
Exactly. Yeah. So tell me a bit more about the Celtics, though. They were doing well last year, and then they kind of faded.
Well, they lost Gordon Hayward, who they signed as a free agent from Utah, who played his ball at Butler there in Indianapolis, and he played in the same gym where they filmed the movie Hoosiers. You know, he's a top 10 player, and he broke his ankle the first game of the year. So he was out the entire year. Then Kyrie Irving got injured towards the end of the year. So, and when Kyrie Irving has the ball, nobody can guard him. And the Warriors can contest, you know, to that when they were trying to win their second NBA championships. It was Kyrie Irving that won it for the Cavaliers, not LeBron James.
Well, let's speak about the L.A. Lakers, mainly because the best basketball player on the planet is now in L.A., and that's LeBron James. And can he, without the same type of talent the Warriors have, other than for James, really rally that team. Let's face it, LA Lakers have a young team. They are talented. But, you know, James is actually going to be the dominant player.
Well, I don't think one player is as great as LeBron James, and he is the overall best player in the NBA. I don't think he can carry the Lakers. The Western Conference is much tougher than the Eastern Conference. You have the Warriors, you got Houston, Utah, and Denver and Portland are much improved this year. Overall, top to bottom, it's a stronger conference than the Eastern Conference.
I mean, that would appear to be the case, but it's going to be interesting to me, at least, to see how far James can meld and mold the Lakers into a team as the season goes along, as the others adjust to him. And again, they are long. The Lakers are long, and they're young. They can run. They can board. What about Lonzo Bell? Does he make a big difference to that team?
He's only playing, he's only starting right now because Rondo is, suspended for a few games. I think they're better with Rondo. But we'll see if Lonzo Bell, his problem has been shooting and defense. He can pass and he can rebound. And fortunately, this year his dad's been quiet.
Good point. Yeah. Well, locally,
I think the Lakers are one year away because they could sign a premier free agent next year, and I think it's going to be, Anthony Davis of the Pelicans, or it could be Kawhi Leonard of Toronto. I think those are the players that they're looking for. I don't think Klay Thompson, who's going to be a free agent, I don't think he's going to leave the Warriors. I think the Warriors are going to pay up. He's not going to take a discount.
Well, you know.
Plus, the Warriors are moving into their new arena next year, so that's going to be a big moneymaker for the Warriors management.
It's interesting that you commented that Anthony Davis might end up in L.A. because he has been quoted recently as saying that he is already the best player in the game. Now, he's not, of course, but he is inching closer. And if he played alongside LeBron James, I mean, that would be an incredible duel.
That's where the Lakers' weakness is center and defense, and he would take care of that. They can't sign two premier free agents. They could sign one.
Yep.
So I think if they get Anthony Davis, Kawhi Leonard, all ball players love playing in Toronto. He may want to sign with the Clippers.
Well, I think if given the chance, he'd probably want to play alongside LeBron James, knowing what the potential then might be with a talented but young team headed by the best player.
But the Lakers'
basketball.
Biggest need is at center.
Mm-hmm. Well, there aren't a lot of centers out there right now. The one that was most available and most appreciated for talent, even though controversial, was DeMarcus Cousins, and he signed with the Warriors. So let me ask you about the Sacramento.
And it's a one-year deal.
Yes. Let's talk just briefly about the Sacramento Kings. As you know, I used to be general counsel until I moved to Geneva, Switzerland. And it's strictly by coincidence that they started going downhill. It is by coincidence. It has nothing to do with me. But it's been 12 seasons and counting since the Kings last made the postseason. That's the longest active streak in the league. And I think you can safely bet that it'll be 13 by the time April rolls around. Vlade Divac is a very, very good basketball mind, but what do you think about the drafting that he's been doing? Is it going to, he's getting talented but young players, and they haven't meshed yet, that's for sure. What are your thoughts there, if any?
Well, he's been drafting a lot of one-and-done players.
Yes.
And it's going to take several years to build the coalition and for those players to physically and mentally mature for the game. So I think he's on the right track, but the Western Conference is much more powerful than the Eastern Conference. So it could take longer. I think if they were in the East, they would win a lot more games.
Well, they've certainly they've had enough years to improve dramatically, and they haven't. So we'll go ahead. Let's find out what happens. All right, I want to transition over to collegiate basketball, and I realize that it's early, and so this is really going to stick you with difficult questions to go out on a limb. You know, Kansas had three of their starters depart, and yet in the preseason poll, they are ranked number one. And
correct.
So how do you see the collegiate basketball world shaping up this year?
Well, Sports Illustrated has, I think, Kansas number one. You can't count out Duke because of Coach K, and you can't count out Villanova. They have an excellent coach, and they've won two of the last three tournaments. And you can't count out Kentucky. They had most of their players coming back, so, and another strong recruiting class. So I think those are the teams, you know, to watch out. But there's going to be a dark horse, you know, during the season.
Well, you know, the Associated Press, like Sports Illustrated, had Kansas number one with over twice the number of votes the second-place team, Kentucky, had. But these rankings came out right as the program in Kansas finds itself entangled, if you will, in the federal corruption case tied to payments used to steer recruits to certain schools. And that's a topic that we'll come back to. But is Bill Self under investigation himself?
Not that I'm aware of. I think maybe one of his assistant coaches. I can't remember if Kansas is a Nike school or an Adidas school.
Explain what I know what you mean by that, but explain what you mean by that for the listening audience.
Well, if it's a Nike school like Stanford or Oregon, University of Oregon in Eugene, most people don't know that, you know, Phil Knight went to graduate school, got his MBA at Stanford, and he's the most prominent alum at the University of Oregon, and he's donated, I think, over $250 million to the University of Oregon, not only in athletics, but, you know, to academic side. And then he's donated about $100 million to Stanford.
But in addition to that, how does that have to do with players going to a particular school? Has to do,
well,
doesn't
it? Well, because they have these high school tournaments, and the recruits, the coaches, you know, they're recruiting. And, you know, these high school tournaments are sponsored by Adidas and Nike.